We're coming into the dome, really the featured area here at Cosm. That was a 27 meter LED dome.
It's like walking into the stadium.
It's sharper than what your eyes would see from pretty much all the seating points here.
And I think what we've seen is fans are willing to pay for quality.
We paid, I think, about 140 each.
$180.
Couple hundred bucks.
Our team's on the ground shooting with five 8K cameras that are capturing those live streams. And that means for fans sitting here, it's just like being at the game.
It's nothing like being at the link, but it's close.
Hey, go Bears!
We're here for Sunday Night Football, setting up for the Philadelphia game. This is kind of a little tedious part of the operation for us, where we're just kind of in here, you know, making sure everything's ready to go out on the field.
In the US, people are spending more money on live sports than ever before. Cosm, which is run by a former NFL player, is looking to cash in. It acquired the world's largest planetarium company in 2020 and uses that dome technology as the blueprint to go from space to the sidelines, creating a sort of in-between virtual and physical space for fans to feel like they're actually at an event.
So I am in charge of putting all the cameras into position, rigging them around the venue. It should take me a couple of hours to get these up. Just getting things into place. How much of that upright do you see?
See the whole end zone.
Cosm's camera kit is key to creating the sense that you're actually at the game. For the NFL, they place 4 to 5 cameras around the stadium, hiding them in places like the field goal, foam pylons, and even on the rolling Chapman cart.
Without the tech, what are we? It is core to our DNA.
Your typical broadcast camera is really massive. We couldn't have placed those cameras and give the fans that kind of access if we worked with, you know, large format camera.
Using a typical fisheye lens for the massive screen they're showing the game on would come out sort of blurry and create a type of color distortion called chromatic aberration. That's because all of the colors pass through the lens at slightly different angles, which causes them to focus at different points of the sensor. So the Cosm team engineered its own glass with a custom curvature to better align those wavelengths and create a sharper image in the dome.
So it took about 2 years, really, from start to finish to create this incredible, you know, piece of glass. That's what allows us to capture 180-degree field of view. Fun fact, just for you, I actually designed all the markings on the lens myself. So our 50-yard line camera is up there. So it gives you that, you know, C-suite level VIP view of the game, beautiful read. You also have the flash in the corner. That gives you the energy of the crowd and an amazing half-field experience from that side.
All of that work behind the scenes comes down to how it translates in the dome.
We can't have a 5-minute delay. That takes you out of it. You can't see the LED modules. If you see the LED module in display, you're toast.
Here we go, we're in the high wide spot. You can see here, right at the 50-yard line, looking into the stadium. You can see, it looks like we're sitting in the stands with everybody else.
These are actually magnetized panels, and that's a really a nod to us being a planetarium company. We've been building dome displays for decades. That laid us a foundation that we're able then to build upon, and hey, let's figure out how we don't just fly around the stars and the universe together, but how do we go baseline at a basketball game or a sideline of a football game.
Now, I've got to say, we can never actually compete with that fan experience when you're in the stadium. We don't want to do that. That is so special. But we want to be the next best option for the fans that might not be able to get to that venue.
Yeah, I didn't really want to go to Philly for this game. Wasn't in the budget either, and this is the next best thing.
So far, Cosm has one venue in LA and one in Dallas. And they were designed just like new stadiums are, with a range of ticket prices from around $11 for general admission up to hundreds of dollars for nicer seats.
We certainly started with this idea of we wanted the seating to be more like you're in a suite, right? So you can see very comfortable seating here. You're not sitting in bleacher seats.
It's more private though. You have somebody that brings you your drinks, brings you your food. The seats are way more comfortable.
Just like a stadium business model, Cosm stacks its calendar with as many events as possible, from documentary screenings to films and, of course, sports. Ticket prices change with demand as well.
We do want pricing to be approachable. That is the core, but we leverage dynamic tick pricing much like others in the market do. And it's a delicate balance we have to strike. But from a capital and funding perspective, these things don't build themselves. Look, we're trying to take this global. That's the ambition. We're opening Atlanta next year. We're opening Detroit next year. We're opening Cleveland in 2027. We don't just have 40 events a year, 80 events a year. We have 1,200 plus events a year. We started with sports. However, we're expanding into other live elements as well. You can look at performance and music and all these other things that we can layer on. What do fans want? What it was going to take to get them off the couch to go out and interact and experience things.